Yay.
Backstory time. So after Sony Pictures Animation finished making Open Season 2, they realized they were creatively bankrupt. No, actually, that probably happened before they made Open Season 2. But anyway, what did they do? Move on to a new franchise? No, they went to the future to find a new movie idea. In the future, they saw that Madagascar 3, Europe's Most Wanted, was one of the highest grossing films ever. Whoa! So they went back, they copied the plot, and now we have Open Season 3. Where do I even begin with this thing? Most people say this is the worst of the Open Season movies, and given how low the bar is set, yeah. I mean, I guess it was a little bit better than I expected. It was better than Garfield's Pet Force, at least. But other than that, this honestly makes 2 look like a masterpiece. So what brilliant plot did they come up with for Open Season Infinity War? Oh, get ready for this one, it's a lot, I tell ya. So Boog wants to go on this annual trip with the other guys called Guy's Trip.
Guy's Trip!
Could you not think of a better... But conflict arises when we get some hilarious jokes about how being a husband is the worst thing ever, and no one wants to go on Guy's Trip with Boog.
This movie's really emotional, guys. What's Boog gonna do? No one wants to go on Guy's Trip with him!
Also, it's convenient that I'm reviewing this around the Halloween time, because there's nothing scarier than Elliot reproducing. Yeah, Elliot has kids now, and they also aren't in the fourth movie. So I guess this means he either ate them or something, or there was a part on the Open Season timeline where he opened another dimension and erased them from existence. That didn't happen in this movie, so it's sadly not getting a 10 out of 10. Sorry. These characters are really pointless. They all have one character trait, and it feels like whenever the writers came to a blog in the script, they're like, oh yeah, we can use these characters. They exist. I remember them. Sadly, since he is now a father, Elliot cannot go on Guy's Trip.
I actually cried during the scene. It was super sad because I realized I was only 5 minutes into the 75-minute movie. No!
So Boog then goes on Guy's Trip alone and he does some stuff. Yay! This plot is very engaging, you guys. Yeah. When we got to the point in the story where Boog is just fooling around, I was like, oh no, did they copy Toy Story 2 again? Were they really gonna have Boo get kidnapped or trapped or something, and then the other animals have to go save him? Well, yes and no. I mean, I guess it's a bit more original than 2, I'll give it that. But anyway, Boo's plane crash lands and he needs to get out of there quick, but he finds a train with a traveling circus and- wait. Wrong movie, I'm sorry. So Boog finds out there are other grizzly bears in the circus, and he wants to go there because he is lonely and because apparently he is the only grizzly bear in this entire forest. But it turns out one of the circus bears is
evil
and plans to betray Boog. You see, this bear, whose name is, I don't know, Soog, he wants to get out of the circus, but he needs another bear to do so because apparently he himself is too weak to lift one of these carts. Even though he is literally a bear and he can, you know, like smash it or something, or like eat the humans or run or something. Aren't grizzly bears supposed to be strong? Why is it so hard to lift a measly cart? I mean, in the first scene of the movie, we saw Boo breaking some wood for the beaver, yet later in the movie, he can't lift the cart even though he can break the cart. Why can't you just get out of the cart? It's not that hard. Also, Boog simps on this other bear because that's totally an original subplot to have in an animated film. Also, look at Soog's model. It's literally just Boog's model. Maybe this would be funny if it wasn't obvious this movie had the budget left over for Open Season 2, which was the budget of vending machine change. Sadly, Pet Paradiso does not make a comeback in this movie, so we can't see the amazing water effects. But speaking of Pet Paradiso, you know who did come back? That's right, the pets! Or at least some of them, I think. I haven't thought about Open Season 2 much since I finished my review, but I'm pretty sure there were more pets than this. But oh boy, lucky me, they kept Mr. Tilt the Frame Dog, my favorite. They also added this new dog for some reason. I forgot his name, so I'll just call him Foog. He literally does nothing for the plot, and I don't even know why they added him. But at least the pets have this absolutely amazing subplot where they go to find Boog for no other reason other than they're bored.
Group hug!
Of course, they fail to find Boog, which means this was all just filler and useless, but hey, at least it gave me like 2 chuckles. That's worth something. If it wasn't obvious already, this movie's plot is barely even a plot. It's not the kind where it doesn't follow a typical story structure because the writers were trying to convey a deeper theme on a deeper level, but more the kind where it's obvious the writers were smoking drugs.
smoking drugs.
Just fix it.
It's really disjointed and weird. A plot point would literally come up, but then not be brought up again for 30 minutes and you forget it's even in the movie. Like, there's this point in the movie where the llama and Boog are talking and they decide to make this chat called Guys Chat.
Guys Chat!
Are you actually kidding me?
Hey everyone, welcome to Guy Reviews, and today we're gonna review Free Guy. So Free Guy is about this guy who lives in this guy. So what are Elliot and all the other beloved open season characters doing during this movie?
Literally nothing.
All they do is just sit around and be stupid until the plot demands them to go rescue Boog. Anyway, so Foog, wait, no, that was the dog. Anyway, so Soog goes back to Boog's house and expects him to be king of the forest or something. Honestly, I'm kind of siding with Soog on this one. I mean, don't bears usually eat animals? I'm sorry, I'm not caught up on my open season lore. I missed the part where Boog became a vegan. But since his design is literally just Boog's design, he doesn't have to do much to fool these animals. All he does is rub... I absolutely refuse to call that mud. I don't want to say a bathroom word in this video though, so I gotta think of a replacement word. All he does is rub Open Season 3 on himself. Meanwhile, Boog is trying to convince the girl that he's not Soog, though I don't blame the girl for not noticing because Boog and Soog literally have the exact same models. This is literally the stupidest plot ever. But once Boog does convince the girl that he is Boog, conflict arises. You see, Boog spending so much time with his new girlfriend means he doesn't have time for guys chat. Oh, the humanity! This makes, what was the llama's name? Boog very angry. But anyway, that's resolved when Boog tells them they can chat later. Yay! But even more conflict arises when Boog tells Boog that they're going to Russia in 3 days and he doesn't have time to escape the circus.
Even though he can always, you know, like, break the guard.
Once Elliot and the others find out that Boog is in trouble, it's up for them to rescue him. Also, this was one of the only moments in the movie where I chuckled. Imposter. Generic climax, engage, aw yeah. So Elliot and the other animals form a plan to break into the circus while Mr. Weenie and Foog and the others drive the car down to the circus, even though they can literally just go out the top of the car like they did the first time. But during the circus, the open season characters get sucked into the circus acts and it's very hilarious and amazing and wow. But once they finally find him, Boog decides he wants to stay with the circus. But then he decides he wants to go home with Elliot. But then he decides he wants to stay with the circus. But then he decides he wants to go home with Elliot. So yeah, Boog goes home with the girl bear, yay. And if you're worried about Boog being lonely, don't worry, Soog shows up because he had a character arc or something, I forgot. You know what, that was absolute garbage, but at least it's finally over. What was I even expecting? I mean, it's better than the musical number from the end of the last movie, I guess, but... Welp, that was Open Season 3, and it was exactly what it sounds like. Everyone has compared this movie to Madagascar 3, and that one's a million times better. Better animation, better story, better villain, better characters, better everything. It's just watch Madagascar 3. Open Season 3 is just a weird, confusing mess. At least I can say Open Season 2 was a weird, confusing, kind of funny mess. This movie barely got me to chuckle or smile outside of the masterful dog subplot, which I'm sure if they submitted it for best animated feature would totally win.
Fussy.
Yeah.
Nine.
Yeah.
Nine.
Yeah, you know, some animals are much kinder once they've been
fixed.
The story's weird, the characters are unnecessary or boring or stupid or all of the above, the animation is gross, everything is just, It's clear that nobody working on the sequel really cared about it, and they just put out the most stupid and weird story imaginable, and they didn't care when it turned out to be garbage. Once again, I feel like I was too mean to scared silly. I am bumping my rating up to a 1.54 out of 10. I used to think it was one of the worst things ever, but little did I know, its two older siblings were even worse. Well, open season 3, that's quite an impressive accomplishment. I was just about to give this movie a 1 out of 10, but the pet subplot convinced me to be nice, so yeah. I'm going to give Open Season 3 a 1.5 out of 10. Yay, we're finally done with these Open Season sequels. This movie was so bad that not even the people who made it could deny how bad it was. Sony Pictures Animation stopped making Open Season sequels for a while and made much better sequels, so they're much better movies. And years later, they even tried to redeem the Open Season franchise by making a sequel that actually tried and connected to the original film. Which, I mean, sure, it was awful, but A, in an extra 0.04 for effort. But for now, these are the only Open Season sequels we have, and none of them are good. And I guarantee you, their next sequel will be 10 times better than all three of these combined. So yeah, bad movie. Come watch my mental breakdown when Open Season 5 comes out. Thank you all so much for watching. Make sure to like the video if you enjoyed, comment down below, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time. On the road again.